Ed, and I'm going to teach you how to use the Blaster Bolt plugin in Final Cut Pro. Here's some footage that me and my brother shot of our toys. But it looks pretty good, but we should add some laser bolt effect to it. What I'm going to do right now is open the Slow Inspector, which is an icon right here. It will be easier to work if I also turn off the skimmer. Just make sure these little icons aren't blue. And down here, you can click the generator effects. It's a little countdown icon. It has a number 2 on it. There's that. All you need to do is click FanFilmFX, and the laser bolt plugin should show up. Let's do the free version first. So all I do is drag it on top of the footage for where you want the laser beam to start. And if you hit play, you can see that it animates itself. The timing is already set to the same speed as the laser bolts in Star Wars. We watched Star Wars Episode 4, and we noticed that all of the laser bolts seem to be 3 or 4 frames long. If you want it to move slower, just stretch it out. So we can aim the laser beam by moving these green and red dots around. Green is always where the laser bolt starts, and red is where it ends. And what I usually do is put the red dot at the edge of the screen, so it looks like it goes off the screen. You click the blaster bolt effect itself. You can go to inspector, you can see the thickness. There's also stuff like glow about that we could adjust. The visibility checkbox just turns the laser on and off. And the show wireframe button shows a line between the green and red dot. Since the snow speeder has 2 laser guns, then I can just copy the blaster bolts and there it's that pasted on top. So then I move the green dot to the gun and then adjust the red dot a little bit. Now it looks like the snow speeder is going towards us, so for the blast it needs to look like it's going towards us. But for the free version you can't do that. So for the full version, you can adjust the thickness to make it look like it's going towards the screen. Now I'm going to move the blaster bolt, the full version, to where I want the laser beam to start. And it basically works the same way. Except now I can adjust the thickness from the red dot to the green dot. So if I change the thickness from the red dot, then it looks like it's getting bigger towards us. And I can do that in the inspector, adjusting the end width. There are also a few extra controls down here. They let me make the lasers look any way I want. I can make the sensor lighter like a lightsaber. I can stretch up the motion blur, which will make it look like less animation. If I don't want a red laser, I can change it to any color I want. Even pink. And if the laser needs to go behind something, I can turn on the cutout mask. And when you turn the cutout mask on, there are 4 little gray dots, so you can move them where you don't want to see a laser beam. So now I'm just going to add some sound effects and more laser beams. And this shot's going to look pretty cool, guys.